What does it take to create a production-ready model? Let me illustrate using this U.S. electrical outlet cover. I have used this model before, but I want to show some new things in the newer version of the software. Notice how user-defined expressions are used. NX displays these user expressions in a folder in the part navigator to make it easy to access them to edit the model. Before you edit someone else's model, first look here to see if the designer created expressions to make life easy for you. Another thing to notice about this model is how I have organized the features into expanding and collapsing feature groups. I'll show you how to do that. The name of each feature group helps to identify the purpose of features. It also makes it easier to find and edit them. Let's start at the beginning. I am deleting everything in this entire model. I delete everything except for the datum coordinate system so we can start over from scratch. The first thing I like to do in a new model is create named expressions. I use the Tools tab and the Expressions command. I'll display just the named expressions that I will create. I want to create the expressions for the overall height and width. In the name column, I type height, and in the formula column, I type the value. I do the same thing for the width. The default unit is length, using millimeter units, so I don't have to change that. Okay. I start by creating a sketch for the outlet cover plate. I create a symmetrically centered rectangle using the from center method. I edit the two dimensions to use the height and width expressions I previously created. After checking that the sketch is fully constrained with no auto dimensions, I finish it. In a second sketch, I will create the geometry for the outlet cutouts. I start with a circle. Notice that I purposely sketch the circle off-center and then align it with the center point. I dimension the diameter of the circle. The easiest way to sketch equal parallel lines is to sketch a rectangle. I sketch the rectangle with two opposite corners on the circle. I drag the third corner to constrain it to the circle. I dimension the height of the rectangle. I next convert the sides of the rectangle to reference curves, but I purposely don't trim the sketch. More constraints are required if I trim either the circle or the rectangle into multiple pieces. I mirror these curves to create the geometry for the second cutout. I then dimension the center-to-center distance. Before I go on, I check that the sketch is fully constrained with no auto dimensions. I extrude the outer rectangle, selecting it using the curve rule of connected curves. I blend the edges of the front face. The easiest way to select these edges with one click is to select using the curve rule of face edges. I use the shell command to hollow out the part, deleting the back face. I extrude the cutouts, selecting with the curve rule of region boundary curves. For the end limit, I use through all with the Boolean option of subtract. I use the draft command to draft the faces of the cutouts. The easiest way to select all the faces I want to draft with one click is to use the face rule of feature faces. I hide all the sketches I have used so far. To create detailed rib features, I sketch on the back face. To create two centered parallel planes, it is quickest to sketch a rectangle using the from center method. I dimension the spacing and the length. Because I plan to use the rib command, the length does not matter, but I dimension the length so that I know that the sketch is fully constrained. I convert the vertical lines to reference curves, but I don't delete them because they are helping to keep the rectangle constrained. To create cross bracing ribs, I start with two angled lines. I dimension the endpoints of the lines. Then I constrain the two lines to be the same length. I mirror these angled lines about the x-axis. Then I mirror the set of cross braces about the z-axis. Again, I check that the sketch is fully constrained without any auto dimensions. After I finish the sketch, I use the rib command to create the rib network. I include a draft angle on the rib for manufacturability. For the boss, I start with another sketch on the same back face. This time, I sketch one circle. I sketch it larger than it needs to be, and then I dimension the diameter. I extrude this sketch with a draft angle to create the boss. To create a hole, I want a centered point to define the hole location. I create a sketch on the front face. To create a centered point, I select the origin of the coordinate system on the other side. Notice how the point is projected to the sketch plane. I use the hole command to create a clearance hole for the fastener. The specified fastener is an ANSI number 6 screw with a countersunk head. For those of you outside the US, this is similar to a metric M3 screw. The hole feature creates the correct size for the screw clearance hole, including the countersunk on the front and a small chamfer on the opposite side. The last thing I add is some additional cosmetic edge blends into corners. I select these edges using the curve rule of tangent edges. I like the model so far, but let's get serious about making this a production-ready model that meets company standards. I select all the datum features, of which there is only one in this case, and I right-click and choose Feature Group. I name this group Datums. I select the next four features and create a feature group named Basic Shape. I select the next features and put these into a feature group named Shell and Draft. I select the sketches and features used to create the ribs and the boss and create a feature group named Detailed Features. Likewise, I create a feature group named Holes. Finally, I create a group named Cosmetic Edge Blends and Chamfers. Let me ask you, if you were asked to edit this model, which would you prefer? This? Or this? Companies that create excellent products require modeling excellence. I hope this video has been useful to you. Important techniques to notice are the use of expressions, using untrimmed, carefully constrained sketches, adding draft angle for manufacturability, and using named feature groups.